Hey, so this is a follow-up video to my post about the Roto-Pax 1 gallon gas can mounting idea on the CT125. I do have mount set up here, which, by the way, I'm aware of the fact that I'm now a dude shooting a YouTube video of a motorcycle and talking about a motorcycle. So yeah, I'm gonna go around the bike and talk about some stuff, and I hope it's not too boring. But this is the Roto-Pax L-bracket. I ended up getting some different hardware and mounting it this way using the existing brackets that came in the kit. I changed the bolts out to go with some shorter ones. And I ended up only using what I would call 2 6-millimeter into the back of the existing rack. I've got the can mount here. I'm doing a terrible job of filming, and it does fit. So let me see if I can get a shot here of what it looks like. I had to remove the toolkit from the original Honda toolkit. The can has to go this way, and you cannot slide it up because of being blocked out by the reflector off of the license plate. But if you slide it in at an angle, and it's a good thing that these turn signals are rubber mounted, if you slide it in at an angle, it pops right in like that. And then you take the, what you call this, the thing that turns, and you tighten it up and everything, and it'll lock on there. I installed my MotoSkill center rack and the headlight bracket, what do you call it, headlights crash guard and front storage rack. I put one of these RAM mounts on for what's going to be an Android, like a ruggedized Android phone for GPS. It's shockproof, waterproof, has a good battery and all of that. So that's what I'm gonna use there. First of all, this thing was really expensive. I didn't even know how much it cost till I got to the register. And it's really nice, but someone can just twist this off and take it. So not real secure as far as leaving it on your bike when you walk into a gas station or a grocery store or something. I've got about 300 miles on this now. We did a pretty rough ride on the Hurricane Creek road / trail, and already with, well, first of all, I got that bike muddier than any motorcycle I think of all time. It was just covered in this like silty, disgusting mud. I've washed it twice and I'm still finding mud in crazy places. I messed around with risers on the handlebars. I did a 30-millimeter and I ended up not liking the handling of the bike after changing that. I removed them and went back to the stock height, and I'm just gonna leave it. The only reason I wanted the taller was for if I'm riding standing up, kind of in technical stuff. I'm kind of tall and it was kind of like I was leaning over too much, but I'd rather have it feel better handling all the time. One thing I changed is I took the rubber out of the foot pegs here. I like this more as far as like strength or more grip on your boots, but it does lower your foot down more and it feels like you start hitting the rear shifter more. I did with my boots. Also, like I said, about 300 miles, I've already got a loose chain. Look at that. So I'm gonna have to adjust that here quick. And then the only other thing that I will comment on is I whacked the crap out of my rear brake on a rock and bent bent it up pretty bad. I don't know if I'm gonna buy a new one or just leave it, or maybe I'll try to hammer it out straight. It still works okay, but it's just, you know, wrong. Starting to get some wear from my boot on the kickstart and wear on my exhaust shield there. That's it though. I did slip on the rocks in Hurricane Creek and went over once and got a little couple of nicks here on the front brake. I haven't decided if I'm gonna do bark busters or some kind of guard for there. I probably should. So my buddy Angelo and I are talking about taking these bikes on possibly Transamerica Trail. He wants to do the entire thing. I can't do the whole thing. I want to do the West Coast side. I want to start in like Trinidad and go to Oregon. But we're going to do a full-on test ride next month on the Smoky Mountain 500 route and see if these bikes are doable or not for that. Anyway, I think that's all I intended to say. I'm going to put a link for the webpage where he will be, Ange will be posting up our combined edited videos from our travels together. I'll still put some little clips up on my YouTube as well, but on that channel will be definitely, you know, our adventure vlogs, right? Oh, last thing. I screwed up my speedometer. So I scratched the surface of it really badly in that mud. So when we did that Hurricane Creek ride, these bikes were like still showroom new. I didn't have hardly any dirt on it. I'd only ridden it around the neighborhood. I'd ridden it to work a couple times. And we decided to do the Hurricane Creek Trail, and it was way slicker and muddier than we expected. I did that trail a few times back in the late 2000s, and I didn't remember it being that bad. Anyway, this bike was covered in this orange mud, and a lot of it washed off when I went through the creek crossings. But at one point, the whole motorcycle was like orange. And it was completely covering mirrors and all the controls. And I wiped with my glove. I tried to wipe it off. And I essentially sanded it into the... I don't have my key, so I can't turn it on. But basically, this is all like just scratched up and fuzzy looking. And it's really disappointing to me that I did that. Anyway, check out the channel. I'll put the link up again, and we'll keep updated on what we're going to do with these things. Thanks, bye.